on.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
I wish you all and your families a blessed and a happy Easter. And we begin our Easter Mass with the blessing and sprinkling of Easter water. Dear sisters and brothers, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers. And for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and the still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. For you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy. For through water you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon with the human race. And last of all, through water, which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our sisters and brothers who at Easter have received their baptism through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter addressed Cornelius and his household. You must have heard about the recent happenings in Judea, about Jesus of Nazareth and how he began in Galilee after John had been preaching baptism. God had anointed him with the Holy Spirit and with power. And because God was with him, Jesus went about doing good and curing all who had fallen into the power of the devil. Now I and those with me can witness to everything he did throughout the countryside of Judea and in Jerusalem itself, and also to the fact that they killed him by hanging him on a tree. Yet 3 days afterwards, God raised him to life and allowed him to be seen, not by the whole people, but only by certain witnesses God had chosen beforehand. Now we are those witnesses. We have eaten and drunk with him after his resurrection from the dead, and he has ordered us to proclaim this to his people and to tell them that God has appointed him to judge everyone, alive or dead. It is to him that all the prophets bear this witness, that all who believe in Jesus will have their sins forgiven through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad.
This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end. Let the sons of Israel say, his love has no end.
This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad.
The Lord's right hand has triumphed. His right hand raised me up. I shall not die. I shall live and recount his deeds.
This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the work of the Lord, a marvel in our eyes.
This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Since you have been brought back to true life with Christ, you must look for the things that are in heaven, where Christ is, sitting at God's right hand. Let your thoughts be on heavenly things, not on the things that are on the earth, because you have died, and now the life you have is hidden with Christ in God. But when Christ is revealed, and he is your life, you too will be revealed in all your glory with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sequence. Christians to the Paschal Lamb, Paschal victim, offer sacrifice and praise. The sheep are ransomed by the Lamb, and Christ the undefiled hath sinners to his Father reconciled. Death with life contended, combat strangely ended. Life's own champion slain, yet lives to reign. Tell us, Mary, say what thou didst see upon the way. The tomb the living did enclose, I saw Christ's glory as he rose. The angels there attesting, shroud with grave clothes resting. Christ, my hope, has risen, he goes before you into Galilee. That Christ is truly risen from the dead we know. Victorious King, thy mercy show. Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Let us celebrate the feast then in the Lord. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
It was very early on the first day of the week, and still dark, when Mary of Magdala came to the tomb. She saw that the stone had been moved away from the tomb and came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved. They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, she said, and we don't know where they have put him. So Peter set out with the other disciple to go to the tomb. They ran together, but the other disciple, running faster than Peter, reached the tomb first. He bent down and saw the linen cloths lying on the ground, but did not go in. Simon Peter, who was following, now came up, went right into the tomb, saw the linen cloths on the ground, and also the cloth that had been over his head. This was not with the linen cloths, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who had reached the tomb first, also went in. He saw and he believed. Till this moment, they had failed to understand the teaching of Scripture that he must rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Towards the beginning of his papacy, Pope Francis wrote these words. The resurrection of Christ is not an event of the past. It contains a vital power which has permeated the world. Where all seems to be dead, signs of resurrection suddenly spring up. It is an irresistible force. Often it seems that God does not exist. All around us we see persistent injustice, evil, indifference, and cruelty. But it is also true that in the midst of darkness, something new always springs to life and sooner or later produces fruit. However dark things are, goodness always re-emerges and spreads. Each day in our world, beauty is born anew. It rises transformed through the storms of history. On this Easter day, in the four corners of the world, the Universal Church sings the Alleluia, chants the Gloria, replaces violet with white, dresses the altars, unveils the crucifixes, and rings the bells. In cathedrals and churches, in chapels and oratories, in monasteries and convents, and out in the open air, from Rome to Jerusalem to Carrickfergus and Whitehead, and a thousand places besides, the cry goes up, Christ is risen, Alleluia, Alleluia. The darkness of sin and selfishness, and what they call in theology the mystery of iniquity, which is to say, the presence of evil, these are pierced by the light of the Easter candle, a symbol of hope for everybody who's struggling with themselves, with life, with other people, with this world of ours. Each of us here, without any exceptions, has a personal Good Friday. What is yours called? I know what mine is. We don't have to tell each other. Very often it's private, a private crucifixion. Sometimes it's out in public. But each of us, whether we can share it or not, knows Calvary. We have, yes, our own personal experience of crucifixion. But because of Easter, even if we don't feel it, because it's a matter of belief, the way is now open for us to make a fresh start, to have a new beginning, to find our way out of darkness, and for some of us it might even be hell. There is a way out because of Easter. No matter what our Good Friday is called, no matter how deep our anxiety, it might be depression, diagnosed or not, or some phobia, or an addiction, or the breakdown of a relationship, or some demon from the past that pursues us every day and especially every night. Because of Easter, there is a power beyond us, a higher power, as they say in Alcoholics Anonymous, a transcendence with which we can face whatever life throws at us. This is the meaning of Easter. There is a way out of every hell of human devising, no matter how dark or deep. Even if we can't feel it here and now, it's still true, waiting to be discovered. If only we really believed, if only we really believed in the Easter Jesus, in his resurrection, and what it means. You don't have to be gospel greedy. You don't have to be overly pious to accept this truth into your life. It just requires an act of faith. Yes, I believe that Jesus got out of the tomb. It wasn't a metaphor. It wasn't an image. It was an historical fact, and it has made all the difference. In our religion, do we feel as if we're relating to a dead Christ who was uniquely important, or a living Christ who is uniquely important? If it's the former, religion is going to become exceedingly tedious and onerous and easily dumped. But if we believe that we're in communion with a living Christ, well, in my opinion, the word for that is friendship. And friendship is precious, especially friendship with him. When people look at my face and my life as a priest, a Catholic priest, when they look at yours, your lives, whether you're Catholic, Protestant, outside the Christian fold, struggling with belief, agnostic, atheistic, whatever, what do they see? What do they hear? What do they touch? Am I, as a Catholic priest, are you, whether you're married or single, or somewhere on the spectrum of relationship, are we making this world, our short life, better or worse, or are we neutral? Will we be remembered after we die? What contribution are we making? Where does Easter stand from my perspective? The Irish poet, I quote him often, I just love him, Patrick Kavanagh, I'm sure some of you know him. He once wrote of the early Christian community, "The Apostles' Creed was a fireside poem, the talk of the town. They remembered a man who had seen Christ in his thorny crown." The Apostles' Creed was a fireside poem, the talk of the town. They remembered a man who had seen Christ in his thorny crown. It's over 2,000 years later, and what do we believe? Why are we here this morning? Why do we sometimes not come here on a Sunday? What do we believe? Let's not look at others, but let's look at ourselves. Catholic priest, lay men and women of different ages, perhaps from different denominations. What is my faith? What gives my life purpose, if anything at all? Is there a sense of direction? Is there something to hold on to when the doctor says, you have cancer, you're terminally ill, or someone we love hears those words, or when we experience anxiety or depression or addiction or a broken relationship, is there someone to hold on to? Easter says, yes, there is. Pope Francis, who speaks very often more like a very, very good parish priest rather than Pope, said, "In proclaiming the mystery of faith, we say that Christ is risen in the present tense. The celebration of Easter is not complete until Christ is risen in you and me. Christian not only in name, but Christian in lifestyle." The renewal of baptismal promises. Dear sisters and brothers, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life.
Amen.
We now raise our hearts and minds on this Easter day in prayer to the Father, our hearts filled with joy in the resurrection of Christ. With renewed confidence, we bring all our needs before the Father in intercessory prayer.
We pray for the church. We pray that we will be a church of the resurrection, a church of hope and joy, who continually strive to love and serve others in an effort to give them new reasons for hope and joy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
The stone has been rolled away from Jesus' tomb. May we play our part in rolling the stone away for those who feel trapped by suffering, addiction, famine, sickness, or poverty. May they know the warmth of our love and the strength of our prayers. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We do not have to wait until we have died to experience resurrection moments in our lives. May we trust that the risen Christ walks with us today and every day, offering us moments of resurrection and new life, especially in the areas of our lives where we tend to despair. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Easter is our assurance that God can bring wholeness out of brokenness, hope out of despair, and light out of darkness. May we cooperate in this work and play our part in spreading wholeness, hope, and light wherever we go. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We remember our dead. We especially call to mind those who are with us last Easter, or those we miss even more on occasions like this. Just as we say Jesus is risen and is with us, we pray for the grace to trust that it is the same for those who have loved and lost. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We remember especially in our Easter Mass those who have died recently, Mary McAllister, whose Requiem Mass will take place here this coming Wednesday at 10 o'clock in the morning, and Selina Lydon, whose Requiem Mass will take place next Saturday at 10 in the morning out in Whitehead. And those whose anniversaries we observe, Terry Humphrey, for whom this Mass is offered, and Huey McHugh, Elfrida Walk, Colin McKinney, Al Walker, and Alex Deveney. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God our Father, we thank you for the joy of this Easter. May all who celebrate the resurrection of your Son experience his power in their lives. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Immediately after this Mass, there will be, as announced, an Easter egg hunt. It's only apparently for primary school children, so grown-ups, you're not allowed to trespass. cups will be handed out in the foyer after Mass, and all the eggs are at the front of the chapel over here to this side. Now the gifts are brought to God's altar. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. My Lord and my God. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, and all who serve the church. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. On this Easter day, let us pause to remember our beloved dead. We remember their faces, their voices, all that they shared with us. We remember them with love and with gratitude, and we entrust them to the wounds of the crucified Christ and the resurrection of the glorious Christ. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Nicholas and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
We remember in our Holy Communion on this Easter Sunday, Mary McAllister, whose Requiem Mass will take place here on Wednesday at 10 a.m., and Selina Lydon, whose Requiem Mass will take place on Saturday at 10 a.m. in the Church of Our Lady of Lourdes in Whitehead. We also remember those whose anniversaries we observe: Terry Humphrey, for whom this Eucharist has been offered, Hughie McHugh, Elfrida Walk in Birmingham, and Colin McKinney, Al Walker, and Alex Deveney. We pray also for a number of parishioners who are very seriously ill. On special occasions like this, it falls to me as your priest to acknowledge the many volunteers who make these beautiful liturgies possible: the cleaners, the flower arrangers. The flowers in both our churches are simply incredible. They really are, aren't they? And those who donated money for the flowers, our sacristans, ministers of welcome, word, Eucharist, and music, our wonderful choir, our altar servers, who helped me so much, and their supervisors, and the liturgy group who have overseen all these preparations. Once again, just to remind you about the Easter egg hunt, only for primary school children. With the permission of those of you who were here yesterday evening for the vigil, not least the choir, I will tell you my one and only Easter joke about how the priest at the end of Easter Mass invited the principal of the girls' primary school to come forward and lay an egg on the altar. So that won't be happening this morning, but there's plenty of eggs out there for you primary school children. Again, just let me wish all of you, dear parishioners, visitors to our parish, and indeed those joining us via the parish webcam, a blessed and peaceful Easter. Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless all of us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. We go forth together in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. according to us.